Let's move to Jammu and Kashmir, where the security forces have launched a series of counter-terrorism operations to demolish the cobweb of Pakistan-aided terrorism in the region. Pakistan is trying hard to whip up havoc and violence through continuous terror attacks and infiltration bids in Kashmir. However, the alert Indian security forces are eliminating these terrorists with a commitment to maintaining peace and tranquility in the region. We have a report.
The Indian security forces are carrying out a series of operations to uproot the network of terrorism from Jammu and Kashmir. The terror groups operating in the valley have received a huge setback. Recently, three Jaish-e-Mohammed militants, including a Pakistani national, were killed in an encounter with the security forces in the Pulwama district in Jammu and Kashmir. The security forces launched a cordon and search operation after specific inputs about the presence of terrorists in the area. Meanwhile, security forces also gunned down a militant affiliated with the Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba outfit during an encounter in Srinagar city of the region.
Aaj din mein Srinagar police ek input develop kiya tha Salimar bagh mein एलईटी का जो कमांडर है सलीम परे 2016 से एक्टिव है वो अपने एक एफटी साथी के साथ घूम रहा है। श्रीनगर पुलिस वहाँ पर गई, उसके बाद सीआरपी भी आ गई, कॉर्डन डाले, कॉर्डन डालते ही फायरिंग शुरू हो गया जिसमें सलीम परे मौके पर मारा गया। एफटी वहाँ से भागने में कामयाब हो गया। हम लोग उसको फॉलो करते रहे और जाके गुसू में दूसरा विलेज में उसको हम लोग कॉर्डन डाले, फिर आर्मी भी ज्वाइन कर ली, फिर दूसरा इनकाउंटर में आर्मी सीआरपी पुलिस मिलकर दूसरा एफटी को भी न्यूट्रलाइज कर लिया।
As Kashmir is heading towards more peace and prosperity, Pakistan, being envious of its development, is busy hatching woolly plots to incite terrorism in the valley. Just a few days back, India's border security force recovered a huge haul of arms, ammunition and heroin near the border district of Samba in Jammu and Kashmir. The recovery was made based on inputs received by the border forces that found the arms, ammunition and contraband drugs hidden in bushes in a white sack.
हमें सतत लगातार इनपुट मिल रहे थे पिछले कुछ समय से कि सीमा पार से इस प्रकार की घुसपैठ या तस्करी आर्म्स एमिनेशन या नारकोटिक्स की हो सकती है, उसके लिए प्रयास किए जा रहे हैं। तो उसके मद्देनज़र हमने अपनी जो सतर्कता बढ़ाई हुई थी और हम पूरी तरह से तैनात थे और ये जो प्रयास किया गया था वो हमारी ट्रुप्स की तैनाती की वजह से ये विफल हुआ है और ये बहुत अच्छी रिकवरी बीएसएफ ने की है और एक आगे बड़ी ट्रेजडी हो सकती थी इनका इस्तेमाल करके, उसको रोका गया है।
On one hand, Pakistan is refusing to change its modus operandi, and on the other hand, the notorious South Asian country is inviting India to the SAARC meeting. Islamabad's desire for a summit doesn't sit well with its recent attempt at infiltration into JNK. Moreover, India's neighbor rediscovered enthusiasm for holding a SAARC summit in Islamabad is likely aimed at shoehorning the Taliban as the representative of Afghanistan.
Pakistan sometimes makes a lot of humor, I would say. On the one hand, they are not ready to accept whatever terrorists they are infiltrating into India. And recently what happened in Karen sector where a bat team man was killed, and also in the international border area of Arnia where another infiltrator was killed. They refuse to accept their bodies and refuse to accept them as their people from there. And on the other hand, they want India to come and participate in SAARC. SAARC was actually made for the cooperation between all these countries, and Pakistan is the biggest impediment in this SAARC movement, because Pakistan is not stopping its infiltration, it's not stopping its terrorism, exporting it to India and other countries also. And therefore, India would be better off than rather attending SAARC.
Instead of holding a SAARC meeting, which is unlikely to yield any meaningful outcome, Pakistan should rather focus on addressing India's concern on countering terrorism. Otherwise, New Delhi on its side has many other options to tackle the nefarious agendas of Islamabad.